Hello and good afternoon from Proactive New York. Joining me today from GinsGlobal is Anthony Ginsberg. Anthony, good to see you. How are you?
Great to see you, Christine.
Lots going on in the tech sector at the moment, specifically with the FAANG stocks. Before we get to that, talk to us about some of the digital media holdings you have in your Hanjin's Tech Megatrend ETF.
Yeah, our Tech Megatrend is actually equally weighted, Christine. So our digital entertainment piece is only one of eight sub-themes, and each one of our holdings is essentially about a 1% weighting. So digital entertainment for us means everything from video streaming all the way across to things like Spotify, video games, online gaming as well. Firms like Nintendo are in there. Of course, Netflix as well. Our FAANG exposure, incidentally, is very, very underweight relative to folks like the NASDAQ, whereas almost half their index is comprised of the FAANGs plus two or three other stocks. We actually are basically sitting with our FAANGs at about a 7% weighting. So we're significantly lower than most tech firms. I would just say that FAANGs obviously cut across a number of our sub-themes. So we've got eight sub-themes, obviously digital entertainment being one of them, electric vehicles and other cybersecurity cloud. So things like Amazon are actually sitting in the cloud. They're actually doing very well in the cloud. It's the other part of Amazon that has obviously hurt them recently. But if I just segue back to Netflix, Netflix has got three potentials to really still grow very strongly, in our opinion. They're trying very hard to get into the gaming area. They made an interesting acquisition in California, where I am, very recently. And we saw Microsoft obviously buy Activision Blizzard recently for about a 30% premium. So gaming is an area that Netflix could segue into. The other two areas that Netflix could probably boost their revenues is to start introducing advertising like Hulu, Disney Plus, HBO Max. Some of those guys are finding their subscribers will pay a discount by accepting some measure of advertising. And obviously Asia is another area that Netflix is underrepresented. They're pushing in there, but their numbers are still pretty weak. So if you assume Asia will be second only to the US in terms of subscription levels going forward, that's another exciting area of growth for them.
And you mentioned Amazon. Amazon reported its first loss since 2015. So what can they do to kind of turn it around?
Yeah. So actually, the part of Amazon that we love is actually their cloud computing. It's really a cash cow. It's basically covering all the losses from my wife and others buying up stuff in the driveway because they're not making much. They've got very, very narrow margins on their regular retail or prime delivery. So it's actually the cloud computing that has really been sustaining them. But obviously, this past month they had, or quarter, they had this increased costing, both with their labor and their deliveries, and they had some supply shortages, supply chain issues. So for us, the cloud part of the business is incredibly healthy. It's actually the other areas where they may have to increase their delivery fees or their charges slightly because they've got wafer thin margins. But interestingly enough, Amazon is also trying to move more strongly into digital entertainment and gaming as well. So a lot of these guys are starting to compete increasingly. But again, we're generally speaking underweight the FAANGs because we see a lot of the mid-cap and even small-cap tech stocks being ripe for acquisition. Obviously, prices have been knocked down significantly the last month and a half, 2 months. So we see a lot of value in the mid-cap space. And don't be surprised if you see more M&A acquisitions, particularly in digital entertainment, which is, again, not just the video streaming stuff, but also the gaming area particularly.
And of course, we can't leave out Twitter, your South African friend, Elon Musk, buying Twitter. What do you think about that?
Well, I think it's quite amazing. He obviously had Jack Dorsey and others pushing him to do it. The interesting thing is they're going to take it private now. I wouldn't be surprised if after they've cleaned it up in the next 3 to 4 years that they go public and they do an IPO and list it again for an increased valuation. They're obviously trying to figure out better ways to generate revenue. Twitter has never been a major revenue generator. I think they're going to really reinvigorate the business. So many of us are actually quite positive on the acquisition, but it may take some time to be re-engineered.
All right. Well, Anthony, it was great to see you and get your take on this. Thanks so much.
Thanks, Christine.